good news of the grace of God. Acts 20 and verse 24. But none of these things move me, nor do I count my life dear to myself, so that I may finish my race with joy at the ministry I have received from the Lord Jesus to testify to the gospel of the grace of God. So the Apostle Paul was announcing this good news about the grace of God, that when Jesus Christ came into this world, he was making God's grace available to all of us. So think about this. As John writes in John 1 and verse 17, he says, "For the law came through Moses, but grace and truth came to us through Jesus Christ." So through Jesus, God's abounding grace becomes available to us. You know, what does grace do for us? First of all, the Bible tells us by grace we are saved. Salvation is brought into our lives because of God's grace. It is God's gift of eternal life. It's God's free gift that through which we are saved. It is the grace of God that sets us free from the power of sin. For where sin abounds, Paul wrote, you know, the grace abounds more and more. And the grace of God sets us free from the power of sin. It's the grace of God that administers righteousness to us. Paul writes, he says, "We have received abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness." And because of God's abundant grace and his righteousness, we reign in life through Jesus Christ. And so Paul says, you know, I've got good news of the grace of God. Today you and I can rejoice because we are recipients of God's amazing grace. Paul writes in Ephesians 2 that because of his amazing grace, he has raised us up together. He has made us sit together in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus so that he can put that grace on display through what he has done in our lives. So we can take time to celebrate. And as we celebrate Jesus, we can say, God, thank you for your grace, the good news of the grace of God. The grace of God saved me. The grace of God pulled me out of where I was. The grace of God set me free. The grace of God enthroned me with Christ in heavenly places. God, thank you for your unlimited, amazing grace. The coming of Christ is good news of abundant grace. That's something to be thankful for, to rejoice about this Christmas season. Thank him for the good news of great joy. Thank him for the good news of salvation. Thank him for the good news of God's grace. Thank him for the good news of his kingdom. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for your abounding grace made available to us through the coming of your Son Jesus into this world. Thank you for your grace in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.